are in embryology chapter 5, that is development up to third week. So we have understood that till second week we are having bilamellar disc. So in the third week it integument forms the 3 layers. So according to name only, in the second week two weeks means 2 layers are formed, that is our epiblast and hypoblast. In the 3 weeks, 3 layers are formed, that is nothing but our ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm. So now let us see how those 3 layers are formed and what are the process. So what is going on in this third week of our pregnant female. So let us understand in detail. So now this bilamellar disc by second week, right, it is formed in the second week. So this undergoes the process of gastrulation. So gastrulation is a process which takes place to convert the second week, that is bilamellar disc, into trilamellar disc. So the now the new trilamellar disc is formed. This is also known as gastrula. So let us understand by this simple picture, like what happens, how this 3 layers are going to form now. So actually, if you cut the embryo in a transverse section and if we observe it from the top, it looks like this in the third week. So this is it's better to show with a pen so that a tip can show you. Yeah, so this is a cephalic end. Cephalic, as the name you can understand, it's like head end, right? So this is a cephalic end and this is a caudal end of a cut section of an embryo in the third week. So the cephalic end, mainly the starting part, you can see there is buccopharyngeal membrane. As the name you can understand, buccopharyngeal means now it is going to form mouth and all its parts which are present near to a head, right? So the cephalic end, this is buccopharyngeal membrane, and before it you can see the procaudal plate which is formed. So there's a procaudal plate and here forms a notochord. So how notochord forms, let us understand later. First remember that here's a buccopharyngeal membrane, here's a procaudal plate, and here's a primitive strake with a primitive node in it. So here the primitive streak forms and here's a primitive node forms, and the end part is a caudal end, right? Here the cloacal plate forms. Cloacal plate where future anus forms, rectum, all those structures, that is end part structures are forming near the cloacal plate. So primitive streak and primitive node are formed. So what is this primitive streak and primitive node? So nothing but the cells which are present in the epiblast. Now this is an epiblast layer, right? So in the epiblast layer, the cells, they just start migrating towards this node and also towards this streak. So as they this streak having inside groove and this pit is having inside node is having inside pit. So all the cells start moving into this and they replace our hypoblast layer, and replacing the hypoblast layer, they form the endoderm first. And in middle of this epiblast layer and the newly formed endoderm, the some cells are remaining from the mesoderm. So this is how endoderm, mesoderm, and now this layer is called ectoderm. So this is how the trilamina layer. So this is like a overview in a simple note. Now let us see point wise here, and also remember that in procaudal plate, both the epiblast and hypoblast are sticky with each other, and also near this cloacal plate and this caudal end, this part there is no mesoderm in between them. That is only ectoderm or endoderm, or you can also say epiblast or hypoblast, are very sticky with each other. And this primitive node, how notochord forms? So let us understand that too. From the primitive node, some cells go, and in the middle they form midline structure notochord. And even near the notochord there is no mesoderm, but you can understand below it is having endoderm and upper it is having ectoderm. So this is how you can understand an overview of a third week development. So let us see in a form of words so that you can get a clear idea completely. So cells from the center of the streak, longitudinally deep lesions, groove is formed, and the movement downwards forming, they are also proliferating, their flask shaped cells, and forming middle mesodermal layer and also an endodermal layer by replacing the hypoblast. That is what we discussed. So they produce a fibroblast. This is important. They produce a fibroblast growth factor 8 which diffuse laterally. So because of the production of that growth factor, it induces the growth and the cells just go on going deeper and forming endoderm and next mesoderm. So 3 layers are formed. That is first ectoderm, mesoderm, and later endoderm. So decrease in echetherins is also, echetherin is nothing but, as the name you can understand, like etherin, that is it is adhering the molecules, that is it's sticking the molecules. So if you decrease this echetherin, the stickiness gets decreases, so that the cells will become free, loose, and they can easily move towards this pit and also groove, right? So they help to bind cells tightly actually. So now the cells become loose, and the cells from the node move like tube forward up to procaudal plate. Yeah, as I said, the cells of the node move up to this procaudal plate, forming a notochord in between. So in adults, actually, we don't have this notochord. It is replaced by our vertebral column. And but as we said, notochord is present, then there should be proof even in adult, right? So its remnants are present in the form of nucleus pulposus. So we'll also discuss it. So cephalic end, that is head end, widen because of the cells are increasing more in there by caudal end proliferation, right? Because the proliferation apparatus, that is our primitive streak node, all are present in our caudal end. So because of this proliferation going on over here, it leads to widening of a cephalic end when compared with caudal end, because of more cells are moving towards this end, that is forming mesoderm, endoderm, and also notochord. So all there is accumulation of cells towards the cephalic end, we can say. So this is how we complete our next coming to. So in which areas mesoderm is absent? This is very important to remember, because we should know where mesoderm is absent. So it is mainly absent in a procaudal plate, as we discussed, because here only epiblast and hypoblast, that is our ectoderm and endoderm, are highly sticky. So there is no chance of mesoderm to separate them, right? And also in the back of pharyngeal membrane, of course, in the front, and in the back of the streak, that is a primitive streak back area, that is towards our caudal end, in a maybe cloacal plate, right? Even in cloacal plate, there is no mesoderm to separate them. And next, at the notochordal tube, yeah. So, yeah, between the ectoderm and endoderm. So actually, notochordal canal also forms. Notochordal canal forms. It is nothing but that is this canal, inside canal forms, which is the central axis of the embryo. And this notochordal canal is situated between the ectoderm and endoderm. As I said, there is also no mesoderm in the notochord. And this central axis of embryo, and it open upward in amniotic cavity. See, you can observe this is no notochord. So the upper balloon is amniotic cavity, and below is yolk sac. Till now what we have read, right? So upper, it opens into amniotic cavity, and below it's having the definite yolk sac. Now the first, we know there is primary yolk sac, next is converted into secondary yolk sac, and next now into definite yolk sac. So below it is having our definite yolk sac, and above it is having amniotic cavity. So it becomes continuous above with the amniotic cavity and below with the yolk sac. So the floor of notochord along with the endoderm fuse. So what they are saying, floor of notochord, this is this floor part, and the endoderm are getting fused, and amniotic fluid connect to the yolk sac. That's what they are saying, because upper it is connecting with the amniotic sac, below it is fused. So now amniotic fluid from the upper compartment easily come into the lower compartment now. So this is also called neuroenteric canal. So neuroenteric because upper ectoderm actually forms neuronal structures, and below endoderm forms our gastrointestinal structures. So it is called neuroenteric canal, as the name neuro, ectoderm structures, neuro upper amniotic cavity from amniotic cavity, and enteric canal, that is towards endoderm. So it is GID system. So neuroenteric canal. So in adults, that's what I am saying, in adults the notochord remnants are present in the nucleus pulposus. So all the three layers are mainly developing from the epiblast, right? Will you agree? Because epiblast only undergoing that primitive streak node and allowing its cells to form other three layers, right? So, and endoderm is towards enterics, are forming enteric system in future, and mesoderm forms most of the muscles in our body, and ectoderm forms a neuronal system or also central nervous system. So what is teratogenesis? So teratogenesis is a major problem during gastrulation, because by substances known as teratogens, like alcohol or any other drugs or anything, this may not only those addictive drugs, also are normal drugs which we use for therapeutic use, even those some may cause side effects to our developing baby. So this is nothing but teratogenesis, and very important stages during gastrulation. So let us see, if there is a high amount of alcohol intake in an unaware female, if she doesn't know she is pregnant and she is taking high amount of intake, then you know alcohol is highly lipid soluble, so it can easily cross the placenta and easily enters the fetus and destroy. So what it is mainly destroying? The damaged developing cells, that is damaged organogenesis, even organs cannot form properly. So 3rd week to 8th week is the most dangerous time for any case of pregnancy, because the formation of organ system takes place, that is very vital. Because if this any kind of teratogen going and attacking it, it may surely cause a damage to our structures of, so it mainly damages midline structures like eyes, nearer eyes become nearer, and it is called as hypotelorism, and also under development of forebrain and lateral ventricle is also getting nearer, also they may fuse with each other. So all this is taken under a condition known as holoprosencephaly. As the name only can understand, holo, hole, like they're having many hole, prosencephaly, like you can remember, like all midline structures are coming nearer in this case. So yeah, till now we complete this. Now let us understand through this diagram. So here's the ectoderm, here's the endoderm, here's the intraembryonic mesoderm. This is important. Till now we have discussed in our before stage in bilaminar disc extraembryonic mesoderm, if you remember. Once here, let us recap. So here the yolk sac, and this is the extraembryonic mesoderm. You know, it forms inner splanchnic layer, outer somatic layer, right in middle extraembryonic mesoderm. This extraembryonic mesoderm only later converts into chorionic cavity, if you remember in our last lectures. So what happens is, they are saying that this extraembryonic mesoderm is completely different from intraembryonic mesoderm, because intraembryonic mesoderm is formed by our epiblast or also ectodermal cells because of entering into primitive streak, all those things. So that is intraembryonic mesoderm, and the outer one, this is the extraembryonic mesoderm. So next, what happens is, notochord tube will form like this. You can see a tubular structure over. This is a notochord tube, and later there is more amount of proliferation going on and forming a notochordal plate like this. One side it gets open, and next forming finally a definitive notochord. In a definitive notochord, it is having an important role in our nervous system. So next we are here. Sometimes there is a postal end, a posterior end or caudal end dysgenesis, that is improperly formed caudal end. That is because mainly due to underdevelopment of caudal mesoderm. So this is your caudal end, right? Caudal means this part. So this caudal end having some inappropriate mesoderm. Why this is all taking place? This is because of a female with mainly diabetes. So if a mother is having diabetes, that to very high ranges of diabetes which is uncontrollable, then the fetus may get affected by caudal dysgenesis. So the caudal place, caudal organs all get less, that is under development of mesoderm. So what happens in this condition is, both lower limbs may get fused or also not well developed, and there is so this is known as hypoplasia or fusion of lower limb, and abnormal vertebral column also may form. Renal agenesis may take place, that is hypoplasia, and also there may be abnormal genitalia, because these are all located towards the caudal end of the body, right? And also there may be imperforated anus, that is there is no hole or in our anal cavity, right? So this is together known as caudal degenesis, or is known as sirenomalia, caudal dysgenesis or sirenomalia. So we have learned some two different kind of names here, like in the case of this holoprosencephaly, all midline structures are joined if a teratogen like alcohol is taken by pregnant women, that is holoprosencephaly. And this is caudal dysgenesis or sirenomalia. Sirenomalia means all caudal structures are dysfunctioned here. So actually mesoderm, intraembryonic mesoderm is further divided into like somites, intermediate mesoderm, lateral mesoderm. We'll see these diagrams and details in our textbook next part. So this intermediate mesoderm mainly leads to formation of kidneys, urogenital system, okay. And it's coming to during gastrulation, the ventral part along with the cilium, they control the concentration of molecules during gastrulation mainly. Control the concentration of molecules, that is right and left structures. So clinically, this presents as dextrocardia, that is there is opposite side heart, heart it should be right side, then dextrocardia means heart is on left side. And not only this problem, sometimes every organ may be present in the opposite side, then it is known as situs inversus. So in this this is also a problem taking place during gastrulation, where the ventral part gets fused with the cilium. And 20% there are in situs inversus patients, some may be normal, but some 20% people may have additional problems, like their cilia may be dysfunctional in their body, and that is because of dynein proteins are abnormal. If you remember, dynein proteins help in movement of cilia. So if the dynein proteins are abnormal, this may lead to cilia dysfunction, and in male there may be infertile and in respiratory sinus, there may be problems leading to chronic sinusitis because all the mucus, it doesn't get out. And in lungs also, there is abnormal dilatation of bronchi that is causing bronchiectasis. So this is together known as Carta-Jenner syndrome. So three important names we have learned: holoprosencephaly in the case of female taking alcohol, that is pregnant female taking alcohol, and caudal dyskinesis or sirenomalia in case of all caudal organs are improperly formed, and Carta-Jenner syndrome. Carta-Jenner syndrome in situs inversus, where all the organs are in different site, and also different problems like male infertility, respiratory sinus and lung problems. So by this we complete the development of third week or conceptual understanding. Now let us see in our textbook some of the important diagrams and some of the other points which are not covered here. So some of the important points which are not in that notes is nothing but the allantoic diverticulum arises from the yolk sac before the formation of the gut. This is important. So after formation of the tail fold, it is seen as diverticulum of the hind gut. That is the allantoic diverticulum. And the pericardial cavity is derived from the part of intraembryonic coelom that lies cranial to the procaudal plate. And the developing heart lies ventral to the cavity after formation of head fold. The pericardial cavity lies ventral to the foregut. And the developing heart is dorsal to the pericardial cavity. So what is septum transversum? It is mainly made up of intraembryonic mesoderm that lies cranial to the pericardial cavity. And after formation of the head fold lies caudal to the pericardium and heart. And liver and diaphragm develop in relation to the septum transversum. So these are some of the highlights of our lesson 5 which are not found in that. And our primitive knot or primitive node is also known as Hansen's node. That is one more important point. And our primitive pit is also known as blastopore. So let us understand some of the diagrams over here. So you can see, as I said, in our diagram, same procaudal plate, primitive knot, primitive streak, local membrane, blastopore are also known as primitive knot, right, and notochordal process. And here you can see the procaudal plate, primitive knot, primitive streak, if you see in the, from the side view. This is blastopore, right, how the cells are migrating, right, notochordal canal. And this is, you can see the notochordal process in the intraembryonic mesoderm. Notochordal canal is formed, next to tube is formed, next definitive notochord is formed, and notochordal plate is formed. So this is how you can see. And next, precaudal plate. Precaudal plate, not procaudal. Precaudal plate may also form the forebrain and eye. That is one more important point which I found in textbook. And let us see here these diagrams now. So the same everywhere, procaudal plate, but now they are dividing the mesoderm divisions. Also we can see in this diagram clearly, this is a paraxial mesoderm, this is a lateral plate. As the name you can understand, laterally, towards lateral, lateral plate mesoderm, paraxial mesoderm, intermediate mesoderm. Intermediate mesoderm is between lateral mesoderm and paraxial mesoderm, right? So it is intermediate, means in between paraxial and lateral plate mesoderm. And down you can see primitive streak, and this is a cloacal membrane, notochord. So next, the B1 is, so if you see like this from front to row, you can understand this is a paraxial, ectoderm, lateral plate, intermediate. Intermediate is between paraxial and lateral, and this is a notochord. So remember that besides the notochord, there is paraxial mesoderm, next we have intermediate mesoderm, next we have lateral mesoderm. So paraxial, intermediate, lateral mesoderm. And next you can see the neural plate, how it is forming somites. This we will also see in our notes in further detail. Now just let us understand diagrams, that is enough till now. So this is neural plate, lateral plate mesoderm, extra embryonic mesoderm. So you can observe one thing, that extra embryonic mesoderm is continuous with the intraembryonic mesoderm, and also the extraembryonic coelom will be continuous with the intraembryonic coelom. This is important point. And you can see somites. So this paraxial mesoderm is only forming this triangular structures, that is somites, and this is a notochord, and the same intermediate, and what is this mesoderm? Lateral plate mesoderm. So as I said, paraxial mesoderm forms somites, which are triangular masses. And lateral plate mesoderm, we also seen on those structures. So now let us check out. And remember that intraembryonic mesoderm is not chorionic, because as I said, extraembryonic sorry, extraembryonic coelom forms chorionic cavity later, but intraembryonic meson coelom doesn't form the chorionic cavity. And now already see the structures. This is intraembryonic coelom, intraembryonic mesoderm. Intraembryonic coelom opens into extraembryonic coelom here, and neural groove. This is splanchnopleuric intraembryonic mesoderm. This is somatopleuric intraembryonic. So intraembryonic mesoderm is also divided into outer and inner. That is, this outer one is the splanchnopleuric intraembryonic mesoderm, and this one is the inner one is the splanchnopleuric, and outer one is the somatopleuric intraembryonic mesoderm. And here now we can check out the amniotic cavity, intraembryonic coelom, yolk sac, extraembryonic coelom. So in this diagram you can easily understand that extraembryonic coelom is continuous with the intraembryonic coelom, and also extraembryonic mesoderm is continuous with the intraembryonic mesoderm. And the next diagram here we have is ectoderm, endoderm, procaudal disc, amniotic cavity, somatopleuric intraembryonic mesoderm, intraembryonic coelom, future septum, transversum, splanchnopleuric intraembryonic mesoderm, and yolk sac. So formation of head and tail folds, how they are formed, you can understand by this. So first only we are having amniotic cavity, yolk sac cavity, and you can see the amniotic cavity is forming like this. It is like a mushroom structure, and downward you can see this is the yolk sac, and this is the head fold, and this is the tail fold. The amniotic cavity, foregut, midgut, hindgut, this is vitelo-intestinal duct. So this yolk sac only gets thinner, and it is forming the vitelo-intestinal duct, and this you can see this is the definitive yolk sac. So in the definitive yolk sac we are having our vitelo-intestinal duct. So next this is all about stages in establishment of umbilical cord. So how umbilical cord? So amniotic cavity, yolk sac, next we know extraembryonic mesoderm, trophoblast outer layer, embryonic disc, connecting stalk is formed. Of course, extraembryonic mesoderm, amniotic cavity, placenta, yolk sac, connecting stalk. So connecting stalk is a future umbilical cord which connects with the placenta. So connecting stalk, amniotic cavity, so finally this is the structure. So extraembryonic coelom is here, gut is here, remnant of yolk sac, future umbilical cord, and vitelline duct. This is vitelline duct. So before we call it as vitelo-intestinal duct, now we are calling as vitelline duct. Now you can see the section 2. So if we cut the umbilical cord, how, what it has, you can see outer way amnion, umbilical vein, remnants of vitelo-intestinal duct, remnants of allantois which is from the endoderm, and the umbilical artery, right and left two umbilical artery are present in a section of an umbilical cord. So we're having many diagrams. Let us check out all with the patients. So amniotic cavity, yolk sac, extraembryonic coelom, allantoic diverticulum. So this is how allantoic, from the yolk sac itself you can see like some projection, allantoic diverticulum, mesoderm of the connecting stalk, hindgut, amniotic cavity. And here you can see the embryonic disc showing the neural plate and the related structures. So this red one is a future septum transversum, fusion of intraembryonic mesoderm layers of lateral part. This is future pericardial cavity. So heart forms here, septum transversum, procaudal plate, neural plate, position of intraembryonic coelom, somites, developing spinal cord, primitive streak, crocal membrane. So how can you see how everything is forming one by one in our embryo? Now you can see the embryonic disc and related structures before the formation of head and tail folds. So this is again amniotic cavity, notochord, primitive streak, crocal membrane, allantoic diverticulum coming from the yolk sac, heart tube is here, pericardial cavity is here. So first it is like this. Here's the septum transversum, procaudal plate, neural plate. So that's it. And formation of head and tail folds, again you can see the same going on, heart tube, but here heart tube is formed. Yeah, there is also heart tube, pericardial cavity, bucco pharyngeal membrane is also forming here like this somewhat. That's it, neural plate above. So below neural plate you can see bucco pharyngeal membrane in the diagram. And finally we are here The later stage in formation of a dental floor. So finally, how it forms? Heart tube in the pericardial cavity, buccopharyngeal membrane, foregut, midgut, amniotic cavity, notochord, primitive streak, local membrane, allantoid diverticulum. So once let us check out the timetable of events described in this chapter. Very important. So day 15. Development event is primitive streak appears. So on the day 15, primitive streak appears and also definite yolk sac is formed, that is a secondary yolk sac. And on 17th day, notochordal process appears. Heart tube is seen in cardiogenic area, that is splanchnic layer of intraembryonic mesoderm. And the allantoid diverticulum seen, which is of endodermal origin near the hindgut. And on 19th day, you can see the intraembryonic mesoderm is formed and also connecting stalk is distinguished. On 21st day, the neural groove is seen. At head fold begins to form. On 23rd day, there is closure of the neural tube, which is mainly on 27th day. So this is 23rd day, the closure of neural tube is seen. So this is all about our fifth lesson, that is third week of development. Next, you can see we are going to study placenta, fetal membranes, twinning. Very interesting. So till then, let us take a small break and start again. So like, share and subscribe our channel if you like our videos. We'll try to complete our all MBBS section in this YouTube channel.